Hey guys, I actually made this video at the gym this morning while I was training, but the music was pretty loud. You couldn't really hear my voice too well, so here I am in my living room remaking this real quick. I just wanted to talk to you guys shortly about knee wraps. If you're in weightlifting long enough or just squatting enough volume in general, you're going to need some sort of knee support eventually. I choose knee wraps. There are knee sleeves are another option, but I like knee wraps for a couple different reasons. I like how you can choose where you want to target certain tightness and if you want it tighter or looser. Also, there are multiple ways to wrap, whereas knee sleeves are just really one way. Also, knee wraps are a lot cheaper. I got this from Hook Grip. There are a million different brands that make this. You can even get like an ACE bandage. Honestly, this was about 12 bucks versus knee sleeves. I mean, I know they're Revans. They only sell them in single pieces, so you have to buy two. And also, I think they're like 40 bucks, so you end up spending like $80 for knee sleeves. And they wear out just as fast as knee wraps, so once you need to restock, you can buy, you know, two or three of these for just one Revan sleeve. And these come in the pairs, so you save a lot of money down the road. So I'm gonna show you a couple different ways. There are a lot of different ways you can wrap. I have two knees, so I'll show you two different ways. This is the way I do it first. I call it like a figure eight style. I don't really know what the technical term is, but you can start either above your knee or below your knee, depending on where you wanna target. I have more quad tendonitis versus patellar tendonitis, so I start on the top of my knee. So I will take, depending on how long your wraps are, it kind of depends on how many times you can wrap around your knee also. I have like a medium sized wrap, so I will take 2 to 3 tight wraps on my quad tendon above my knee to start. I'll target below my knee, 2 to 3 wraps after, and then I have all of this extra wrap, so I will figure eight it over my patella. Just back and forth until I end up with about one more wrap's length, and then I'll take that last wrap, pull it over my quad tendon nice and tight, and then you'll take this excess right here and just stick it through there, and you'll pull it tight and secure it itself. So that's the way I wrap it. So you can start on the top or the bottom and do it the same way. Another way I see a lot of athletes wrap their knees is just a straight across wrap. So you can start above or below. For this case, I'll show you below since I did on top before. So you start below, 1 or 2 wraps below, and then you just go straight up across. So I still have this extra wrap right here, so you could either go figure eight, or you could go all the way back down and do the straight across method again. And then you have this excess, we'll tuck it in, pull it tight. So for me, the one negative side of the wraps is as you go along, they will loosen a little bit, and I just hate the idea of them coming unraveled or them even like sliding up and down. Even if they're not sliding up and down, just the thought in my head can throw me off while I'm lifting. So life hack here, you can buy these knee warmer sleeves. They're really not sleeves at all. They don't give much support. They just kind of keep your knees warm. You can buy these off Hook Grip as well. I'm giving a big plug to Hook Grip, I guess, today. Or there's a ton of other companies that make these for cheap. You can even get them off Amazon. Either way, it doesn't really matter. There's a ton of different colors, different brands. So I'll just take these after I'm done wrapping my knee, pull them over the top, they're not going anywhere. They're nice and secure. You can play around with different ways you like to wrap. The one thing I would keep in mind is I like to start from the inside, pulling outside. Because if I'm gonna have my patella biased one way or the other, I'd much rather have it tracking outwards than starting the outside and pulling medially and have it track inwards. So that's just one thing I'd keep in mind. Also, if you're new to this, don't be discouraged the first time you squat or do any lifts, because your mobility might be a little bit different just with the tightness around your knee. It takes some practice, so go into it with that mindset that you're gonna need to practice this throughout your weightlifting career. It will net positive. So if you have any questions, you can leave a comment, I'll try to get to it. Hopefully this helped you. Thanks for watching.